Boy, what a gutty win for Larry Shyatt's team.
The Wyoming Cowboys are off to a 15-2 start and ranked in the AP Top 25 for the first time in nearly 27 years. The Pokes are 4-0 in conference play for the first time since the 2002-03 season. Joining us from Laramie, Wyoming, is the head coach of the Cowboys, Larry Shyatt. Coach, appreciate you making some time. Number one question for me, what has been the secret to you guys' success here in the 14-15 season?
Well, it's probably no secret, to be perfectly honest. We got a great group of guys. So we got a great group of guys and a mature group. Sort of odd dynamic, six seniors, six freshmen, but they mingle and they mix pretty well, and they actually play to a pretty high intellect when they're on the court.
One of those guys who is certainly the leader, Larry Nance Jr., what has it been like for you seeing him go down about 11 months ago, seeing him go through the very tough rehab, and now seeing him back on the court, not only on the court, but having success?
Well, you know, certainly some ups and downs, but from day one, you're talking about a breath of fresh air. A young man that was very humble, not spoiled or poisoned by the recruiting system, came out here and actually took a chance on Papa Shy and took a chance on Wyoming to begin with. And it's been wonderful to watch him grow. A great family, a young man with high value system, and he's a pretty good basketball player as a senior right now.
Recently, your non-conference schedule was criticized in an article for being weak, but I take a look at your non-conference schedule and I see teams like Colorado, New Mexico State, Denver, SMU, Cal, all teams preseason that were slated to compete for their conference title and get to the NCAA tournament. What was your reaction to that article?
Well, you don't really want to react too much to media or articles, but I will tell you this. We're very proud of what we did with our league office and our staff. We virtually had 7 or 8 conference calls. We tried to get people not only that had the last 3 years outstanding RPIs and came in third, second, or first in their league, all of whom you just stated, with the addition of Southern University, who had finished 3-2-1-3 straight years. The lack of predictability of what one is going to do this year maybe hurt us a little bit, but I got to tell you something. Some of my best years, 22-plus years, spent in the ACC, Big East, SEC, and all of my friends and good friends. Shy, we love you. We're not bringing our team to Laramie between December and March. I'm sorry, I'll come up for a fundraiser. Fortunately, Mike Montgomery, before he retired, and Larry Brown were kind enough to give us a 2-for-1. But we reached out to every commissioner of a BCS school, as well as every head coach that I'm aware of, to ask Home and Home will go there first. 2-for-1. And the only two who would return to Laramie for a 2-for-1 was Cal and was SMU.
Part of the reason is the program that you're building and the success that you've had in the Arena Auditorium. And I think the lead up to that, the facilities that the University of Wyoming is building and renovating, I would imagine that's a big reason for you guys' success. How proud are you of the facilities that you have right now and are continuing to build? And what will that do for this program going forward?
Well, the redo was magnificent and timely as well. The odds of them in 6 months, when right after our CSU win, the coaches and players were removed from their locker rooms and the process began. And by October 1st, we were back on the court in a new double A, and it's priceless. They've done a great job, both the architectural firm and the construction people. And kudos to our many donors and our state legislature for being kind enough to put this together, and wait till they see phase two next year.
It's a first-class program all the way. And speaking of first-class, another first-class program coming your way to Laramie on Wednesday. San Diego State coming in, a team that you beat last year in the AA, 68-62, when the Aztecs were ranked number 5 in the country. What is it going to take to beat the Aztecs once again on Wednesday night?
Well, you're talking about probably the best defensive team in the entire West, perhaps one of the best defensive teams in the country, and not only a great coach, but a great staff as well. It's probably going to take everything you just said and more. We're going to have to handle the ball and handle their pressure and speed, and we're going to have to make some timely shots. I'm really proud of where these guys are at now, but I do still think there's some improvement on the horizon. We got a tough week ahead of us. San Diego State stands between us at the moment.
Yep, the top two defensive teams, at least scoring defense, on the court in the Mountain West on Wednesday night. Coach, Wyoming is 26-8 all time against San Diego State in Laramie. Good luck against the Aztecs and the rest of the way.
Well, we appreciate it. Thanks to everybody back there.
That's Coach Larry Shiat, the head coach of the Wyoming Cowboys. By the way, you can watch the Cowboys and Aztecs Wednesday night, 9 o'clock on ESPN2. From the Mountain West Network studio, I'm Jesse Kurtz.